back with Joey here as he goes through his trigger point rollouts. And obviously with this grimacing face, this is something you definitely want to attack. What we're attacking is a particular attachment that sits right behind the outside profile of the foot and can actually sit into the IT band and the knee joint. This is a side trigger point release, really. Probably the first one we go after. Now, it's imperative we go after that and work on those things because they get bound up and tight and then it stops a proper gait pattern, a proper movement function. And if you think about a fighter in his typical stance, he's actually predisposing a tight position in that particular area. Now, you match that or you combine that with pivoting, jumping, kicking, and receiving damage into this at IT band, this area can get really locked up and stop working correctly. And over a period of time, you'll end up overcompensating in, say, the lower back or the knee joint itself when you need to create comprehensive rotation. So it's imperative going after this particular area and releasing the knee joint. You'll typically see it on somebody. If you get Joey to roll up his other pant leg, if you don't mind, real quick. See here, it's getting quite bound up in this particular region. So what we're going to do is go after that particular region on the other side. When it gets there, we're going to keep going after this one. But it's imperative we're getting that to track right, and you're never going to get that tracking right if there's dysfunction present. You can't simply just go after mobility exercises and technical exercises to release it if it's simply too tight. So again, you've got to start your warm-ups working on your tissue conditions. Now, for a lot of fighters that have damage there and have some quad tightness or IT damage tightness, you would spend more time with this. The cool thing with these trigger point rollouts techniques is after a period of time of doing this habitually, you'll have to spend way less time. You get around doing this for 15 to 30 seconds per sub. Because this is his first go at it, we're giving him quite a bit of time. Now, with that being said, you can also spend some time doing this more frequently or with more volume and more time in between workouts, like when you're just hanging out of your cupboard. So a good idea to do after a long engaging fight. Maintain a quick wink, make new moves for your tournament. It's a great way to kind of alleviate the tension you're building with that impact. And everything we do is impactful as we're walking. You can imagine the impact intensifying as we start moving.